You always seem to vacation, no matter what the situation is. There's always something going on. And LeBron James said, I've been doing my thing, kicking butt, getting points. Look at his vacation, y'all. Talking to them. Pull up the team on Turner. Pull up the team on Turner. I mean, they just out having the time of their life. That water is gorgeous. Gorgeous. Kind of plan me a vacation like this. Come for the zoo. Go other places, but I need to be on this water right now. You come like sunshine, yeah, call me the moon. Baby, go fast, so fast, might give her the wound. Who got the hookup? Yeah, come for the show. Adventure. Put up for certain, yeah, come set the moon. Yeah, you come like sunshine, yeah, call me the moon. Baby, go fast, so fast, might give her the wound. Pull up the single Montana. Now, this lady says that she was a manager at McDonald's. And apparently, you didn't have a problem with McDonald's until you got let go or something. Anyway, she's on TikTok, Mighty Self. She says that the way they make the sweet tea, no one should drink it. Let's hear what she has to say. My thing is, none of it is healthy for you. But that's the reason why you go, because you want that treat. You want to indulge. But don't indulge into diabetes, y'all. Don't do that. That is not healthy.
McDonald's. I worked there for about 3 years. And for the tea, they have a red jug for the sweet tea and a green jug for the unsweet tea. Now, these jugs are 4 gallons big. And for every 4 gallons of the red jug, the sweet tea, there is a full 4-pound bag of sugar emptied into it. 1 pound per gallon of tea.
So I need to go check out her page because I need to see what else she had to say. And this is why, in this time in life, that you should be making your sweet tea at home. And all your other food too, because none of it is healthy. Now some of these comments, you don't have to just stick to water. I mean, if you make your own, then you don't have to worry about it being too sweet. You can judge how much sugar you want in it. Me, on the other hand, I want my tea to be sweet. Otherwise, I'm not going to drink it. And I would like some lemon in it. But that's just my preference. You don't have to want the same thing. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, hit that bell notification so you can tune in for the next one. So the Lakers did not make it to the playoffs. Not really shocked or surprised. However, Shaquille O'Neal had something to say in regard to the Lakers not making it to the playoffs. He said that they rely on LeBron James way too much. And at this stage in the game, LeBron is a little too old to be trying to go round for round with these young dudes. They don't respect him as they should, and they don't fear his game. So does that mean that LeBron needs to up his game some more, or does he need to go sit down? In my humble opinion, 30 points a game, that's a lot. It's a lot of up and down the field. The court. I haven't been there. That's a lot. And at his age, he's doing great. He may not be getting as many assists or rebounds. But guess what? He's still playing the game. He's still putting points up on that scoreboard. But anyway, LeBron did his thing. Could he have done better? Maybe. Who knows? Does his age have a real big thing to do with it? Maybe. But his age didn't stop him from putting them points up on that board. And y'all notice how when he get time off, he do his own thing. He chill, he relax, he rejuvenate, and he come back and he whoop ass. So continue to whoop ass, LeBron, regardless if you made it to the playoffs or not. Maybe next year. Maybe not. Y'all leave a comment down below. Let me know what y'all think. If y'all think that LeBron should just give it up. Or if y'all think he should keep playing until his body say, look, damn it, we tired and we're done. What do you all think? Should the Lakers have gone to the playoffs? I didn't watch not one game, so I cannot tell you. But you all can tell me, because it's a part of having this conversation. Thanks for tuning in. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Hit that bell notification. And I will be back. Aisha and Steph Curry need to pat themselves on the back because this beautiful young lady is doing her thing in the kitchen. And there's some things that some little girls and little boys and young ladies and young men haven't learned yet. And that's how to cook. You should always have your children in the kitchen with you while you're cooking or baking or whatever it is you're doing, because you never know what their skill may be. And you never know how good or bad they may be at it. Let them try. If you notice that they're going to burn down the house, you might want to stay in there.
He is making dinner tonight. Tell us what you're making.
I am making a chicken piccata with...
Ooh, thank you, chef. You okay?
That's right. Lay it away from me.
It's her first batch. Chef, what in the world?
She needs it's looking apron, real so good, girl.
I learned from the best.
And let her design her own chicken apron. And look fish, halibut just and chicken breast. I'm so proud of you.
I'm so happy.
That's right. She's
so yummy.
That's cool too. Well, that young lady did her thing in the kitchen. She didn't burn up nothing. Mashed potatoes look delicious and thick. Carrots look delicious. Let's eat. If you're in Tennessee, you better slow your ass down. Slow your ass down.
There definitely should be consequences to this.
The state of Tennessee is cracking down on drunk drivers by calling.
So if you're in the state of Tennessee, you may want to slow it down because they got consequences for you.
There definitely should be consequences to this.
The state of Tennessee is cracking down on drunk drivers by costing them big time. And drivers slapped with a DUI won't
stop
like
drinking
it.
And driving.
You know, just unfortunately, getting off work, off his shift.
Be safe.
Got hit by a guy that was fully intoxicated.
The new law that requires drunk drivers to pay child support for killing a parent in deadly crashes.
He has children, he had a wife. Definitely a tragedy within itself.
The impact on victims' families in Tennessee isn't the only state turning to child support to punish impaired drivers.
I think that is so true. I think that they should. Hold them accountable. Make them responsible for those children or for that family. And then you wouldn't have to worry about anyone else drunk driving, because who can afford that? You have your own family, allegedly. But now you're going to go out and take someone else's life, and now you're responsible for their family. Times are changing.
Colin Kaepernick
says that he still wants to play football despite what all the naysayers have to say. And so he's continuously going out and practicing with other NFL players. And they are giving him his props. They are saying that he should be in the league. Despite him, you know, taking a knee for, you know, police brutality and inequality. He is doing his thing. And they're saying that he should be on the United States Football League. Well, I don't know if he should be on the Football League, but I know that Colin Kaepernick still got it, regardless if he was going out there and not doing his thing or whatever the situation may be. But he was an honorary captain for a game at Michigan Stadium a couple days ago. Let him show you all that he can do it. And if he shows you that he can't, well, then you know what you got to do. But the people were happy to see him. Some of the players were happy to see him. And I believe some of the coaches were happy to see him. He's got to show that he's ready. He has to prove it. He can't just say it. So just going out and doing the practice here and the practice there, that is not enough. He should be at practice every day, throwing that ball, showing he still got it, showing he can run and play, showing he can listen. Shaquille stated undoubtedly that his relationship with Shawnee, his ex-wife, was his fault that it failed. And from what I could see on the outside looking in, she may have had a little fault in there too, but it seems like she was the most embracing and, what's the word I'm looking for? Nurturing. She helped nurture Shaquille O'Neal into what he became. And yes, they had their ups and downs, but they have beautiful children together. And when asked about the relationship between he and Shawnee, he summed it up very quickly. And I quote, "She knows," unquote. Shawnee knows how Shaquille O'Neal feels about her. Will she ever go back to him? I highly doubt it. But if she does, then more power to her, because it is free will. She is able to go and do and see whomever she pleases. So I'm happy that she's living her best life. She's on Basketball Wives. I used to watch it. I don't watch anymore, however. She is a great influence for young ladies to see to a certain degree. There are certain things among that show that no one should be able to see because it is a downright disgrace. However, we're not getting off into that. We just wanted you all to know that Shaquille O'Neal still loves his baby, Shawnee. And because he never has to speak on it, because she knows. Katy Perry and mother freaking Nicki Minaj, y'all.
Hello.
Dear Katy Perry, I love you.
I'm a Barb, everybody knows.
I just saw this lady standing here with very sexy legs and feet, and it was her.
And a tata. And you got a tata, cause why?
Excuse me?
Cause we mothers now.
But Katy still has the best boobs in the business. Period.
That's cute. I'm glad to see that you can be friends with everyone in the industry. They're just having general conversation, making a TikTok, a video for Instagram or for whatever social media site they're on. That is wonderful. Two beautiful women being positive with one another. I love it.